I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 92.1. Questioner, could you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. The condition of this instrument is slightly more distorted towards weakness in each respect since the previous asking. Question 92.2. Questioner, is there a specific cause for this and could you tell us what it is? Answer, I am Ra. The effective cause of the increased physical distortions has to do with the press of continuing substantial levels of the distortion you call pain. Various vehicular distortions other than the specifically arthritic have been accentuated by psychic greeting and the combined effect has been deleterious. The continued slight but noticeable loss of the vital energies is due to the necessity for the instrument to call upon this resource in order to clear the, shall we say, way for a carefully purified service to others working. The use of the will in the absence of physical and, in this particular case, mental and mental-emotional energies requires vital energies. Question 92.3. Questioner, we have been trying to figure out how to provide the instrument with the swirling waters, and we hope to do that soon. Is there any other thing that we can do to improve this situation? Answer, I am Ra. Continue in peace and harmony. Already the support group does much. There is the need for the instrument to choose the manner of its beingness. It has the distortion, as we have noted, towards the martyrdom. This can be evaluated and choices made only by the entity. Question 92.4. Questioner, what is the present situation with the negative fifth density visitor? Answer, I am Ra. It is with this group. Question 92.5. Questioner, what prompted it to return? Answer, I am Ra. The promptings were dual. There was the recovery of much negative polarity upon the part of your friend of fifth density and at the same approximate nexus a temporary lessening of the positive harmony of this group. Question 92.6. Questioner, is there anything that we can do about the instrument's stomach problem or constipation? Answer, I am Ra. The healing modes of which each is capable are already in use. Question 92.7. Questioner, in the last session we discussed the first tarot card of the Egyptian type. Are there any distortions in the cards that we have that Ra did not originally intend or any additions that Ra did intend in this particular tarot? Answer, I am Ra, the distortions remaining after the removal of astrological material are those having to do with the mythos of the culture to which Ra offered this teach learning tool. This is why we have suggested approaching the images looking for the heart of the image rather than being involved overmuch by the costumes and creatures of our culture not familiar to your present incarnation. We have no wish to add to an already distorted group of images, feeling that although distortion is inevitable there is the least amount which can be procured in the present arrangement. Question 92.8. Questioner, then you are saying that the cards that we have here are the best available cards. Answer, I am Ra. Your statement is correct in that we consider the so-called Egyptian tarot the most undistorted version of the images which Ra offered. This is not to intimate that other systems may not, in their own way, form an helpful architecture for the adept's consideration of the archetypical mind. Question 92.9. Questioner, I would like to make an analogy of when a baby is first born. I am assuming that the matrix of the mind is new and undistorted and veiled from the potentiator of the mind and ready for that which it is to experience in the incarnation. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. Yes. Question 92.10. Questioner, I will read several statements and ask for Ra's comments. The first is, until an entity becomes consciously aware of the evolutionary process the logos or intelligent energy creates the potentials for an entity to gain the experience necessary for polarization. Would Ra comment on that? Answer, I am Ra. This is so. Question 92.11. Questioner, then, this occurs because the potentiator of the mind is directly connected, through the roots of the tree of mind, to the archetypical mind and to the logos which created it and because of the veil between the matrix and potentiator of the mind allows for the development of the will. Will Ra comment on that? Answer, I am Ra. Some untangling may be needed. as the mind-body-spirit complex which has not yet reached the point of the conscious awareness of the process of evolution prepares for incarnation, it has programmed for it a less than complete, that is to say a partially randomized system of learnings. The amount of randomness of potential catalyst is proportional to the newness of the mind-body-spirit complex to third density. This, then, becomes a portion of that which you may call a potential for an incarnational experience. This is indeed carried within that portion of the mind which is of the deep mind, the architecture of which may be envisioned as being represented by that concept complex known as the potentiator. It is not in the archetypical mind of an entity that the potential for an incarnational experience resides, but in the mind, body, spirit complex as insertion, shall we say, into the energy web of the physical vehicle and the chosen planetary environment. However, to more deeply articulate this portion of the mind, body, spirit complex as being nestless archetype, the potentiator of the mind may be evoked with profit to the student of its own evolution. Question 92.12. Questioner, then are you saying that the source of pre-incarnatively programmed catalyst is the potentiator of the mind? Answer, I am Ra. No. We are suggesting that the potentiator of the mind is an archetype which may aid the adept in grasping the nature of this pre-incarnative and continuingly incarnative series of choices. Question 92.13. Questioner, the third statement, just as free will taps intelligent infinity which yields intelligent energy which then focuses and creates the densities of this octave of experience, the potentiator of the mind utilizes its connection with intelligent energy and taps or potentiates the matrix of the mind which yields the catalyst of the mind. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is thoughtful but confused. The matrix of the mind is that which reaches just as the kinetic phase of intelligent infinity, through free will, reaches for the logos or, in the case of the mind, body, spirit complex the sub-sub-logos which is the free will potentiated beingness of the mind, body, spirit complex, to intelligent infinity, love and all that follows from that logos, to the matrix or, shall we say, the conscious, waiting self of each entity, the love or the sub-sub-logos spinning through free will all those things which may enrich the experience of the creator by the creator. It is indeed so that the biases of the potentials of a mind, body, spirit complex cause the catalyst of this entity to be unique and to form a coherent pattern that resembles the dance, full of movement, forming a many-figured tapestry of motion. Question 92.14. Questioner, the fourth statement, when the catalyst of the mind is processed by the entity the experience of the mind results. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. There are subtle misdirections in this simple statement having to do with the overriding qualities of the significator. It is said that catalyst yields experience. However, through free will and the faculty of imperfect memory, catalyst is most often only partially used and the experience thus correspondingly skewed. Question 92.15. Questioner, then, the dynamic process between the matrix, potentiator, catalyst and experience of the mind forms the nature of the mind or the significator of the mind. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. As our previous response suggests, the significator of the mind is both actor and acted upon. With this exception, the statement is largely correct. Question 92.16. Questioner, as the entity becomes consciously aware of this process, it programs this activity itself before the incarnation. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Please keep in mind that we are discussing, not the archetypical mind, which is a resource available equally to each but unevenly used, but that to which it speaks, the incarnational experiential process of each mind, body, spirit complex. We wish to make this distinction clear, for it is not the archetypes which live the incarnation but the conscious mind, body, spirit complex which may indeed live the incarnation without recourse to the quest for articulation of the processes of potentiation, experience, and transformation. Question 92.17. Questioner, thank you. And finally, as each energy center becomes activated and balanced, the transformation of the mind is called upon more and more frequently. When all of the energy centers are activated and balanced to a minimal degree, contact with intelligent infinity occurs, the veil is removed, and the great way of the mind is called upon. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. No. This is a quite eloquent look at some relationships within the archetypical mind. However, it must be seen once again that the archetypical mind does not equal the acting incarnational mind, body, spirit complex as progression or evolution. Due to the first misperception, we hesitate to speak to the second consideration but shall attempt clarity. While studying the archetypical mind, we may suggest that the student look at the great way of the mind, not as that which is attained after contact with intelligent infinity, but rather as that portion of the archetypical mind which denotes and configures the particular framework within which the mind, the body, or the spirit archetypes move.